Criminalizing drugs isn't the only path we can choose for drug policy. Decriminalizing them, for example, removes the criminal penalties for certain activities involving drugs, like possessing them. People caught with them won't go to jail, face criminal penalties, or be labeled a criminal and forced to live with a criminal record. Canada is in the worst overdose crisis in its history, and we're hearing a growing chorus of politicians and healthcare professionals calling for decriminalization. Currently, there are around 30 countries that have done this, from the Czech Republic to Mexico, and even some places in the United States. In 2001, Portugal decriminalized drug possession. Afterwards, drug use went down, along with HIV infections and fatal overdoses. Legal regulation is another approach. This means that the government would make using drugs like cocaine and heroin legal, just like it did for marijuana, but it would control their production and distribution and set rules around who gets access to these drugs, along with where and how access is provided. The drugs would be much safer because the government controls their quality. Right now, there is nothing in place holding anyone accountable for the quality of the drugs being offered to people for consumption. Drugs can be mixed with contaminants that can harm and kill. Legally regulating drugs would undermine organized crime and take the drug supply out of their control. It would also allow us to educate the public, ensure safety, and prevent drugs from being accessed by young people. In a legally regulated system, we could avoid the harms of the past and ensure the safety of the future.